content of the following program is not intended to be a substitute for professional medical advice, diagnosis, treatment, or cure. Always consult your physician or a health professional with any questions you may have regarding a medical condition. Go higher, baby. You're in the right place. You're listening to One Life Radio. This is Bernadette with Diamond Gray, Lexi Brinkley, Aviana Barrientos, and Von Eaglin. Hey, guys.
Hey.
Hey, what's going on?
Hey, I'm trying to get this microphone so I can see you because I want to look you in the eye while we talk. I'm big on eye contact. Did you ever notice that about me?
Yeah, every time I'm in the studio, I'm watching you watch me
I'm watching you. So, it's so great to have you in studio today. We have a huge show coming up. We've got Kevin Curry coming in just a couple of minutes, and we're going to do Von Eaglin, Burn On with Von, where you can call in and ask him all kinds of questions. You can ask him anything you want, but we're actually going to be talking about cheating today, right?
Yeah, we are.
Yeah.
That's an interesting topic.
It is, and I think everybody's been affected by it in one way or another. You know, it's just, I think, I don't know, for some people, okay, I'm already burying myself. I'm just going to stop right there.
Keep going.
But I'm really excited to have this show today. I prepared food last night out of Kevin Curry's great book called Fit Men Cook that came out just a few months ago. It's 100 plus meal prep recipes for men and women. Hashtag healthy AF and never boring. So, so I made the avocado tzatziki chicken salad last night. And you'll laugh, I made the cilantro tahini dressing. Mm-hmm. But when I was making it, and I'm like, why is this so thick, you know? And my kitchen is wonderful, but it's a little underlit.
Underlit.
After the sun goes down.
Okay.
It is. And so I see clear as a bell, it's a third a cup of tahini, not a half a cup of tahini.
Okay.
And I doubled the recipe, and I was like, oh, man. Then I tried to fix it, so I'm like, I'm just going to leave it home.
Okay.
You know,
okay.
And try to fix it
I don't know
later,
how you fix that. Do you just thin it out something? I don't know.
You thin it out with water? Well, we'll ask Kevin here in just a couple of minutes. I'll tell him what I did.
That's so awesome. I've been following Kevin for many years. So I had a friend of mine who was a model, and he always said, you know, you need to start doing a lot of meal prep in order to get the results that you want. And so he said, you need to follow this guy, Kevin. And so I've been following him for maybe like at least 3 years.
Wow.
And I've seen his, you know, I guess, all of his viewers or people that view his video go up. And he's kind of like a celebrity to me. So I'm going to be doing this little fanboy thing when he comes in the studio.
Yeah,
so.
No, he is. He's a big guest.
I'll try to.
He's a big guest and he's hot like you. two hot guys in the studio with us today. So, I'm really looking forward to it. And everyone that knows me knows I absolutely love to cook. I was in heaven last night because it's not like forced, but I was forced to cook, even though it's never a force for me. And try something new. And I love a lot of his messages in the book about love your leftovers and just a lot of things that make perfect sense. And here he is, Kevin Curry. Oh, my gosh. So good to see you and meet you. Oh,
What's
my gosh.
On? How are you doing?
I'm doing well. I'm doing really well. You see your avocado tzatziki chicken salad over there that I made last night.
Oh, okay. And I'm actually hungry, so.
Oh, good. Well, yeah, and it's 100% organic, and I prepared it fresh last night, refrigerated it overnight, and pulled it out.
It's
just
better
about
that way.
It is better that way because then the sauces have a chance to marry, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah,
they can all meld together. It looks beautiful. I wish y'all could see this right now.
Yeah,
like, I'm gonna take a photo. I'm gonna take a photo. Of
oh wow,
right now
that'd be cool.
Instagram, we have to.
Yeah. Well, you know, and I brought salt and pepper. I don't over season anything because I like for people to season it themselves. So salt, I put a little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper, and then I brought some balsamic vinegar for the side.
Okay.
And I even brought a little sugar in case someone wanted to sprinkle some sugar on
there. A
little
sugar is not too bad.
Salad.
You know, a little bit, right? You can add some flavor to it.
Yeah.
How long did it take you to make it? Oh, man.
There you go.
How long did it take you to make it last night?
I was drinking a little wine and dealing with the animals and everything too, but so probably about, I'm going to say 20 minutes.
Nice.
I sauteed organic olive, not olive breast, chicken breast
in
avocado
breast?
Oil, just low and slow, and got them nice and brown to give it some color too, and caramelize it a little bit. And I don't know, I'm anxious to try if I made it correctly.
You know what? And I am going to try it. I love eating as I talk, so.
Good. I do too. Yes, absolutely. I'm Italian. Of course, I love to eat and talk.
Okay, good. And I'm so sorry for the listeners because I tend to smack, and I just recently learned that about myself. I was watching this video, and I was eating something. And I was like, God, is that me? My videographer was like, yes, we've been meaning to talk about that. You
this
sound
is something
off.
We've been meaning to talk about.
Well, you know, this is awkward, but I'm going to bring it up because it's funny as heck. But when I was at Central Market last night shopping with my daughter to get all the ingredients that I need, she said, Mom, did you know that that peppers are male and female? I was like, what? She goes, yeah, look. And she showed me the end of the pepper. Male and female, and I was like, oh my gosh. So we put a video out on Instagram. It's really funny.
Now I gotta see this.
But if you hold them up, you can see.
You can see. Like they
it looks like
they
one
fit
is,
together.
They actually do.
There's three on one and four on the other.
I'm gonna guess which one. Okay. Oh.
Yeah.
He discovered it.
I did not know that. Hold on. Now I'm gonna put this on my Instagram too. I did not know this.
I know, right? Okay. How could I be cooking and you all these years and neither one? And Lexi didn't know it either.
No.
But, you know.
I'm mind blown today, guys. I just found out that peppers are male and female. So this is the female one.
That's
the male one. And
it's a little
this
elongated.
Is the female one. And look.
They
on,
fit.
This.
Look at that.
Mind blown. I'm mind blown right now.
The more you know.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, I don't even know what to say. It's such a pleasure to have you here. I love to cook. I'm half Italian, half Irish, and I was in the restaurant business for many years. I'm one of the co-founders of Wingstop. A lot of people don't know that, and Pizza Patron. Pizza Patron came first. Wingstop came second.
You've been doing the Lord's work for quite some time.
Well, yeah. Yeah. But, it's funny. When we started Wingstop, we were trying to save chickens. You know, not create like a wing fest,
okay.
If you will. I mean, we thought that, the chicken wing would end up on the floor, in the factory. And we thought, why not turn it into an entree instead of that animal going to waste, using the whole animal to help the environment and everything. So, and then the whole country went crazy. And, now it's crazy. It's publicly traded. It's one of the most successful concepts out there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So put me through college.
It put you through college? Did it really?
Those fries.
Yeah.
The fries.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know what? They should. You know what? Wingstop should get a hold of you to come up with a Kevin Curry wing.
Hey,
right?
There you go.
There you go.
The flavor.
Well, their corporate offices are they're right down the street, so they might
Let's
be listening.
Take a walk
you never
together.
Know.
Okay. Let's take a walk on over there with the founder.
Oh, my gosh. This is so crazy. You know, Kevin, for people that are listening and don't maybe have not heard of Kevin's book or don't know about Kevin, I don't know how that could happen, but if you haven't, Kevin Curry is the founder of Fit Men Cook, and it's an online community that inspires men and women to eat healthy and stay fit with healthy recipes that, in Kevin's words, are never, ever boring. And they're not. I have to tell you. I'll tell you the tahini story here after I give your intro. But he's got over 2 million followers around the world and has become one of today's most sought-after personalities in nutrition, health, and wellness. Kevin recently released his first book, as I said, Fit Men Cook. It's 100-plus meal prep recipes for men and women. Always hashtag healthy AF. I almost said it. Oh my gosh. Better check myself.
Healthy A bleep.
Never boring. And he released a book in December of 2018, which is when he graduated from Cal University and immediately went to the top of Amazon's fitness category within a month. And since the launch of the book, Fit Men Cook, Kevin has been featured in national online publications such as Forbes, Men's Health, Self, Shape Magazine, as well as television appearances on Live with Kelly and Ryan, Rachel Ray, The Rachel Ray Show, Today, and many others. And as I said, it's great to have you in studio. What a big personality you have.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate that.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Are you like that? Are you fun in the kitchen?
I feel like I am. I feel like I am. I have fun in my head. And so, yeah, I think that translates into the kitchen.
Yeah. Well, Vaughn has a bro crush on you because he's been following you for years.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, man.
This is so embarrassing, Vaughn.
I had a friend of mine who's a fitness model. And he said, you know what? If you want to get your results, then you need to do a lot of meal prep. Follow this guy, Fit Man and Cook. And then I followed you maybe like 3 years ago. Now, it's a weird story. I happened to see you by my gym in Kroger's, going into Kroger's. I think you were doing some filming one day. I was like, hey, Fit Man and Cook. You were like, hey, man. I was like, okay, that's it. I don't want to, you know, I don't want to look awkward or anything like that. But anyways, though, I've been following you for years, and I'm so happy to meet you. So
thank you, man. I really appreciate that. Seriously,
yeah.
I do.
And so do you prep?
Yeah, I have to.
That's the main question.
It's a necessity if you want to get some results, because your diet has so much to do with, you know, I mean, let's say you spend an hour in the gym. The results you're going to get are going to be the other 23 hours that you're outside of the gym, because, you know, you cannot outwork a bad diet.
Yeah,
so,
you can't.
And I used to try that all the time. My wife says I would be totally, like, obese if I didn't if I didn't work out. However, whenever I do meal prep, I really get the results that I need.
Yeah.
And I do appreciate all the information you give your viewers.
Thank you, man.
Well, I think you're genetically blessed because, I mean, after all, Beyonce is your, what, second or third cousin?
Well,
I mean,
she's a little further down the line.
Oh, really? You got the Beyonce blood?
Further down the line.
Beyonce blood.
So the story is Destiny's Child sang at our family reunion when I was like 8, 9 years old.
Are you kidding?
How wild would that be?
This was in Anahuac, Texas, back in the day. And I foolishly, I said, you know what? They're not going to be anything. They can't barely sing. And
What did they sing?
I can't remember what they sang. They had on Cross Colors, though. I don't know if you know back in like the 80s, 90s. Mm-hmm. You know what
that's
I mean?
When Mama Knows was still dressing them.
Yeah.
And she would put on all
there you go.
The drapes.
Yeah. So they had some boots on. They were stomping, and they had a whole routine and everything, but it was interesting. So.
It is. Yeah. Well,
that is too funny.
Isn't that
fast
crazy?
Forward,
small world.
80 million records later, I guess.
So. Absolutely. Well, we're going to talk all about this great book. We're gonna make a sandwich here on the break with Kevin's famous avocado tzatziki chicken salad, and and we'll be right back, everyone. You're listening to One Life Radio. You acting kind of shady, ain't calling me baby. Why the sudden change? Say my name, if no one is around you. Call us crazy. We don't mind. Crazy Water's all-natural mineral water has been making people feel good inside and out since 1881. As the only mineral water bottled in Texas, their water boasts loads of benefits that other bottled waters can only envy. Pretty crazy, huh? Find it at your local Whole Foods, HEB, Central Market, or have it shipped right to your door. Visit them at drinkcrazywater.com. That's drinkcrazywater.com.
Wanting to try CBD but not sure what to trust? Check out H-Hemp H, like healthy, happy, honest. H-Hemp's CBD system makes it simple with one CBD tincture, available in 3 great-tasting flavors. A super powerful breath spray that GQ magazine named a top CBD product. And a topical CBD balm that is simply the bomb. So relax and feel better naturally with the H-Hemp CBD system, available at hhemp.com.
You know, my mom always said, do something well or not at all. Frosted Art Bakery has been around a long time, almost 70 years, doing it well. I was so impressed with the cake that I asked them to make for our special guest, Jen Sincero, the author of the book, You Are a Badass. They actually made a cake that looked exactly like the book. It was incredible. But I guess I shouldn't have been surprised, because Frosted Art Bakery has a reputation for being one of the best bakeries in the Metroplex, serving Dallas, Plano, Frisco, Addison, the Colony, and Southlake. Life is short and you only get one. Enjoy a slice of Frosted Art today. Find them at frostedart.com. That's frostedart.com. Welcome back to One Life Radio, everyone. This is Bernadette with Diamond Gray. I've got Lexi Brinkley in studio with me, Aviana Barrientos, Von Eaglin, and Kevin Curry. Okay, so I'm going to introduce the players here today, because we've got a couple of amazing men here in studio with us. Von Eaglin is a licensed professional counselor, supervisor, and works with 2 group practices in the Dallas area. He is a certified couple relationship relationship trainer and sees a wide range of clients addressing men's issues, anger management, abuse, and addiction, just to name a few. He is also a doctoral candidate at the University of North Texas in the Counseling and Higher Education Department. His PhD research focuses on couple relationships dialogue, and you can find him at PrestonPlaceCounseling.com or on Instagram at VonTalks. That's PrestonPlaceCounseling.com or